Hey guys, Orak here, and before I begin this video, I just want to point out that this will not be a video about power speculations or power level discussions and stuff like that, because firstly, I believe, at least with now Super in mind, it is a bit pointless to talk about power levels, and secondly, I just don't like those type of discussions because they create comment section wars, you know. So, yeah, a small disclaimer. So recently I did a poll, and where I said, aesthetically speaking, which do you guys prefer, the Ultra Instinct form or the Super Saiyan 4 form? And to be honest, I was surprised with the results, because a lot of people, I think the poll gathered like 40 or so people that voted, and it resulted to Ultra Instinct winning with, I think, a bit of a difference, you know, in contrast with Super Saiyan 4. And I didn't expect it because Super Saiyan 4 had like 20 years or so to grow to our minds and become this staple of transformation, you know. But yeah, just wanted to point that out. So, when it comes to Super Saiyan 4, in his, you know, appearance, we have this fairy guy with crazy hair on top, with different, you know, colors in his eye, in contrast with his base form, some type of reddish eyeliner. And all this stuff, even though I laugh about it and I think it's a little bit, you know, excessive, you know, it's like the true primal form of a Super Saiyan, and it is good because it differs from the golden Super Saiyan, if you want to call it. And even though the original Super Saiyan 4, trivia for you, would feature a golden fur, but they ended up going with the red fur because they wanted to differentiate it a bit with the original Super Saiyan 4. So, when I view Super Saiyan 4, I think of it like the true Super Saiyan form that quote-unquote the ancient Saiyans strived for. And it is pretty cool, I mean, you can't deny that. But I can see the downsides of it, like for some it is pretty flamboyant and extravagant and all the stuff. So yeah, now Ultra Instinct, I can't really doubt it because it just appeared for one episode and we don't know that much about it. We just know that it is something like Whis's hyper movement, and you don't think but act and let the muscles of your body act independently. And yeah, now in its design, it's pretty minimalistic and but effective in my opinion, because all the things that are different from the base form are the silver eyes, the hair going up, and the crazy aura that is, I would like compare it to the Super Saiyan God aura, because they are so unique in nature. And you know, I can't really say that much about Ultra Instinct because I want to see more about it, and we don't know that much yet and how people can sustain the form, or even if they can sustain the form, or are they conscious in their form or aren't they. I mean, there are so many questions about it. But we can't deny that both forms are symbolic and, you know, have their own meaning, like Super Saiyan 4 being the true Super Saiyan and achieving what, you know, older Saiyans wanted to achieve. And it is considered like a form that is the utmost potential that a Saiyan can throw out. And Ultra Instinct is, you know, pretty symbolic in its own right, because In my opinion, it's like having a new Super Saiyan form that is not the Saiyan form, that in theory everyone could attain it if they trained enough and went to the level of gods in their own right. But I'll make a video on that on a different video. And you know, we can appreciate both forms for what they are. And now, for my personal opinion, I don't really know which I prefer, because we had like 20 years to digest the Super Saiyan 4 form, and now we have like a few weeks for Ultra Instinct. We have to, you know, have to view the whole Tournament of Power so that we can get a better understanding of Ultra Instinct, and maybe then we could like end up in a conclusion. But what's your opinion, guys? I want it on the comment section. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Just a fun discussion, nothing else. And I'll see you soon. Bye bye.